Creo que estás aquí por tu hermano.
¿Conoces a mi hermano Sam?
Si encontramos ese oro, lo encontramos a él también.
How did you make sure that that the movie, as you said, was first a movie and then a video game adaptation?
It's always challenging when you're adapting material that's beloved by its fan base, and I think that you have to treat that source material, whether it's a comic book or a video game or whatever, a novel, it doesn't matter, with respect. Because what people love about the thing, they're also very protective of. And they don't want to see what they love, like the bad version. So whether it was Venom or this movie, I just want to make sure that it passes the test of fans, because ultimately that's who I'm making the movie for. At the same time, it has to exist for people who have never heard of Uncharted, the video game. And it's just a classic, like you said, adventure movie that captures the spirit of the game, but then creates a whole new chapter for film.
Mm-hmm. Speaking of that, what was the most difficult part of creating a young Nathan? For example, I saw that in the video games, Nate is, obviously it's a video game, so it's very lethal. He kills a lot of people, but in the movie, more careful, more merciful. He even says, "I'm sorry" to one of the goons. Why this choice?
Our story is the meaning of Sully and Nathan Drake and his very first ever adventure, which is not featured in the video games. And so I think it's really important that we're telling an original story, that we weren't just recreating the games, and that they were telling a whole new chapter of his adventures. We were lucky enough to cast Tom Holland, who I think is probably the most exciting young actor you could hope to have in your film, and perfectly captures the spirit of Nathan Drake. And that's in part because he's a massive fan of Uncharted himself. And so for him, it was a real dream to get to play this character. But I feel like we did everything possible to respect the source material and also at the same time make it our own.
In some of the games, there's a part of supernatural stuff. And was there at any moment on the table to introduce supernatural elements?
For us, with Uncharted, the movie, we wanted to make it our own. And while there are supernatural elements that are a part of the original video games, over the course of the series, they kind of got less and less featured. And I prefer the more grounded reality of the movie we made. It's not to say at some point, if we're lucky enough to make sequels, that we couldn't delve into that supernatural world. But in the telling of this story, it was very important to just keep it as real, grounded, and natural as possible.
And if you get to do a sequel, do you have a location in your wish list to take Nathan and Sully, or maybe even a crazy stunt that you want them to make after throwing them out of a plane?
So when you're editing a movie, especially one like this, which had such a long post-production process, you can't help but your mind wander and start to imagine different adventures that you can find your heroes on. So I've thought of all different scenarios in which we can put our stars and our heroes and other adventures we can tell, but it all relies on the audience wanting to see another edition of this film. So I really hope and pray that they love this movie as much as I do, and that they connect with these characters and want to see them go on more adventures.
So after throwing them some a lot of water in this one, maybe a snow, maybe the desert. Like,
I mean, you, there's like, if you spin the globe and you can see all the possible places that you can take to find adventures and also connect with history, I mean, it's limitless, whether that's South America, Egypt, anywhere in Africa, really, Asia, it's limitless. And I get excited about all of those possibilities.
Was it your intention to make it like an Easter egg hunt, like a treasure hunt, the whole movie for the fans of the games to look for the cameos or the sticker and things like that?
I'm so glad that you caught all the references that we included in the film to the video games. We try to pay as much tribute as possible, whether that's like you mentioned, a very significant cameo, or it could be a sticker of the video game designer Naughty Dog. There's lines that Nate says that are directly taken from the game, and we even feature the score from the video game at different times of the movie. So we really wanted it to be, like you said, a treasure hunt for the audience as they navigate the film, that they're able to collect these different Easter eggs that we've planted throughout the film.